I'm Himanshu Jain, Diamond Chair Professor of Materials Science and Engineering, and I'm also the Director of International Materials Institute for New Functionality in Glass at Lehigh University. I got interested in biomedical applications of glass after a visit to Cairo, where I was invited to participate in a US-Africa workshop. I met there Professor Mona Murray. She is the director of tissue engineering lab in the Faculty of Dentistry at University of Alexandria. And she mentioned about the problem she was having with her patients, many of whom have been suffering from bone disease, and especially women. We then decided to address this problem as a team, which has included colleagues from her institution and my colleagues from University of Lisbon in Portugal, Princeton, and Lehigh universities. Our multinational collaboration is made possible with support from International Materials Institute for New Functionality in Glass. It is sponsored by National Science Foundation and is located at Lehigh University. We believe glass can mimic physical and chemical characteristics of the bone if it has the right composition and if it has right porous physical structure of the bone. So it should have large pores, macro pores, in which the cells can make their home. It is about the size of 50 micron. We can barely see that size pore. And then it should also have nanopores, where the size is 10,000 times smaller than the size of the larger pores. Our hope is to not use healthy bone, but artificial macro nanoporous glass that will serve the same purpose, and it will be much easier on the patient. Presently, the preferred method is to autograft a healthy bone in place of a diseased bone. Glass has been used for some years to replace bone, but dentists like Mona Murray have not been satisfied with its performance. We believe that glass can mimic the physical and chemical characteristics of the bone. So if we have a glass of right composition and has right physical porous structure of bone, I think we can have a right kind of scaffold for the bone cells to grow on that piece of glass. The purpose of the nanopores is to help these cells attach to the scaffold firmly and also to supply nutrients to the cell. We are using two independent methods for fabricating macro nanoporous glass. The first method is a conventional method where we would melt the right composition and quench the glass to get the right form. In the second method, we are using a wet chemistry method, which works at much lower temperatures. We are the first group to have fabricated this macro nanoporous glass scaffold material.